Hi guys, welcome to part three. I didn't know that I'd be making so many parts, but apparently I have a lot to talk about. So, if you have not watched part two of this little series, you probably should watch that first, and you should probably watch part one. So, I will try to figure out a way to link those, maybe annotations. I don't know if I know how to do that. If not, there will definitely be links below. And so now for part three, I'm going to explain my life after what after Chris breaking up with me. So in my last video, I explained this boy Dave, who I met through Facebook, leaving me and me being devastated. So that was the big thing in my depression. That's definitely what kicked my depression into full gear. I was completely a mess. I just was not myself anymore. I wasn't happy. I couldn't be happy for anything. I didn't enjoy the things that I used to enjoy, and I didn't even hang out with my friends as much, and I would spend my time in my room being alone, watching TV or movies, and if I wasn't doing that, then I was crying, and I cried a lot. It basically felt like I have been. Basically, now it feels as if I have been crying nonstop since my grandfather died. Nothing has been going right. To be honest, nothing has. I mean, even more things, more like personal things in my life have happened. My parents split up, and they haven't been together for 2 years, and that's been hard on me, being the only kid at home. I have a brother and a sister, and they weren't home when my parents split up, and I felt very much alone, very much isolated, and that I even resented my brother and sister a bit for not being there when my parents split up, and for leaving me all alone, and for making me deal with it by myself. They didn't have to see my parents fighting. They didn't have to see my parents ignoring each other. They didn't have to see my dad not sleeping in my mom and dad's bed anymore, and not sleeping at all anymore. Yeah, it's been very hard. I feel as if nothing has gone right. When Dave left, I spent that summer trying to get ready for college. But obviously Oneana didn't work out for me. And last summer, I spent trying to get ready for Oswego, and obviously Oswego isn't working out for me. So now, my depression is bad again. I am currently taking Lexapro and Wellbutrin, and I've been taking Lexapro for about a year now. I started taking it the beginning of the year last year. And that has helped a lot with my anxiety. I don't have panic attacks anymore. I used to get those last year, but I don't get those anymore. And for a while, I was just on Lexapro, and it seemed to help my depression a little bit, but it definitely helped my anxiety more. And at the end of the year last year, when I was taking my medical leave of absence, when my depression was at its worst, I was prescribed Wellbutrin, which was supposed to enhance the Lexapro. It was supposed to make the Lexapro work better, and it was also supposed to help me not sleep as much. I was sleeping all day, and the Wellbutrin was supposed to make me energized, so I was supposed to take it in the morning. And this didn't matter at the time because I didn't have a boyfriend or anything. But my libido had lowered since taking Lexapro, and it had been a problem when I was with Chris, but then he broke up with me, so the low libido didn't really impact me much, but Wellbutrin does tend to increase your libido, so it was supposed to fix that side effect. So, I am on Lexapro and Wellbutrin now, and it's not working. Two days ago, I went to see my psychiatrist in Syracuse, the woman who prescribes my medicine. I wasn't able to see that specific doctor because she was out of the office, but I saw her colleague, and she decided to decrease my Wellbutrin. I was on Lexapro 10 milligrams and Wellbutrin 300 milligrams, but with these types of medicines, these antidepressants, you kind of have to vary the dosage and vary the medications to get your perfect fit, because not everyone can take 20 milligrams of Lexapro and be fine. It depends on you, and so you have to change your dosages quite a bit. So now I am taking Wellbutrin 150. And I mean, I can't say that I've seen any results because it's only been 2 days, but that is where I'm at now, and I'm hoping that I can get level again, because my counselor in Oneana described something to me. She says that people, their emotions are like waves, and everyone has high points and everyone has low points. And it, you know, it being the same amount of high as low is normal. And some people are even more high and just a little bit low, you know? But she described me as being more low and less high. So what the medication is supposed to do is it's supposed to put me at the base level where people generally, you know, live with their emotions. And if I'm up, because right now all of my energy is being spent to try to be at this base level when I'm just depressed all the time. So the Lexapro and Wellbutrin is supposed to put me at that base level. And then my energy will be better spent being more happy. I hope people understand this. So that is where I'm at now. I'm trying very hard to get better. I know that I'm not going to be cured of this overnight, but I'm trying very hard to manage it. To do what I need to do in life to be a successful person and to be a happy person. I'm doing what I need to do, and I'm hoping that the medication will help me in that, because I mean, it's even in the Constitution, you have the right to the pursuit of happiness. And I have that right. I didn't think I did. I thought I was just going to be this depressed person and that I wasn't going to get help. But I know that I deserve to feel happy again. Everyone deserves to feel happy again. And with that said, I hope that my videos can help someone. Maybe not be happy for right now, because it's kind of a depressing issue, but to know that they're not alone, and that there is hope, and that I am a friend. So with all that sappiness, please don't hesitate to comment or message me if you want to know anything further about me, or about depression and anxiety, or about antidepressants. I'll be happy to help, and everyone have a great night, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.